Now, another variation on using your swing indicator is you can make a knit zigzag, which the ribber is going to do the knit stitches, and the knitter is going to have the ribber is going to have the knit stitches, the knitter is going to have the purl stitches. So as the work is facing you, that is the public side. Now, in the book, they have it as the 5x2. You start out with a full needle rib. You do your cast on. Now, that one, you do need to do the circular two rows or three rows. And then we need to transfer stitches from the ribber to the knitter. All the stitches are going to be in work on the knitter, but only certain ones on the ribber are going to be in work here. So because this is a 5x2, I could go ahead and take my, and luckily I have two sets of the bulky tools, is I will take either two or three stitches, I will take my other tool and just get underneath there. Before I showed you just the one prong, but you could do the two prong also. And now I'm going to do the three. Now, the other thing is when you move these to the knitter, is these are offset a little bit. So you're going to want to move them all the same way. I'm choosing to move mine all to the left, that half a stitch. Let me get a close-up view of what I'm doing here. So I take my first tool. I take them off those hooks, and I want to push those needles down to the non-working position. I take the other tool and I go underneath those prongs, and then I have to go one over to the left. Make sure you get the eyelets of the prongs on the hooks, and then just bring it back. Now we do the other two needles. If you're doing a 6x2, 6x3, then of course all you need is that three. And it is best to get the tool up above the ribber. I keep getting caught on the gate pegs there. So now I have those all in work. I make sure the needles empty on the ribber are put down to the non-working position. Now that first row was a little tough because I did have two stitches on almost every needle on the knitter. So just go easy with that. Push it as you can. Now, for the swing indicator, it doesn't matter which way you're going, as long as you're consistent with this. I'm starting out with H3, so I want to go to H2, which is two clicks. I knit one row. Now I'm going to go to H1, again two clicks, knit one row. And then to H0, knit one row. Now I'm going to go back all the way to H6 and then continue just going back and forth. And it's going to create the zigzag pattern on the front or the public side of this work. And as you hear, it is a little tough knitting each row. Just go slow and you should not have any problems. Here is a close-up of me changing the swing indicator. So, as you notice, now this moved one over, and that's why it's going to create that zigzag pattern on the front of this material. And here is the sample I did. So now you could see how the swing indicator was moving the needles over and how it creates this zigzag effect. Well, I hope you get to try this out on something.